helping families have children is one of the most rewarding things you could possibly do, and we're there every day doing it.
I mean, that first question you asked me about, like, why this place? I mean, like, it's like, it was all or nothing for me. There was no other program I was gonna consider. This was the one. Like, this is where I had to start my journey in IVF, because this is where it started here in this country.
I was fortunate to learn under Georgiana and Howard Jones. The fact that this represents the first successful IVF cases in the US is also just phenomenal to be involved in a historical place like this.
Reproductive clinical science is for the students who want to work in the IVF labs, works on the reproductive health industry to become embryologist, andrologist, endocrinologist, or genetic counseling for the infertility treatment. We have 20 years experience as the pioneer for the reproductive medicine. We are the first one for the online master PhD and also the first PhD program for the online reproductive clinical science. We also have the expertise and resources from Eastern Virginia Medical School, and also we are the first program funded by the Jones Institute for the reproductive medicine, who are the pioneers of this infertility world.
I was an embryologist for 20 plus years. You get to a point where you can't go any further until you have a PhD, really. And so I ended up going into the master's after I had already had my TS certification to kind of learn what it was going to be like and how I could move forward in the field. And so once I did master's, I knew I was going to do PhD. So it's a way to grow in the field. When you've already got the clinical skills, this is all the education behind that.
As a working profession, they've been working in the clinical field for such a long time, but they may not necessarily have the certain experience in the basic hands-on mechanism study part. I want them to understand what they are doing, not just the technique, but why they're doing and how can they make it better. That is not only important to the master student, who is usually the first line workers in the embryology lab, but also to our PhD students.
I was already a practicing clinical embryologist full time, and I was part of the very first class that was admitted to the master's program here at EVMS. It has expanded my scientific understanding of why we do what we do. So it greatly increases your ability to troubleshoot and have critical thinking skills.
The RCS program is a hybrid program with online distance learning and also on-set in-person hands-on training with all different aspects of IVF techniques and skills.
Because you get to a certain age and who can quit their job and go back to the university full time? So it was very flexible and able to work with my work schedule, and I could do the classes when I had time.
I'm from New York City. Most of the EVMS course in RCS is virtual, so we do asynchronous lectures. So I work during the day, and in the evenings or on days off, I'm able to decide what time works for me to do most of the work. And then 1 week each year, we come here in person. It's great to meet some of the other people in the field. It's a great networking opportunity. And then we're hands-on, we're meeting the professors, spending time with them.
In the residential program this week, we're working a lot in the lab doing andrology protocols, procedures. We're also doing a lot of embryology procedures. We're even going to be doing ICSI and biopsy, which is definitely a hard piece of experience to get in the field. So that's why this program in particular at EVMS is invaluable, to have that exposure.
So when you get your genetic results back, then you're gonna come back to your patient.
It's very rewarding to come back and teach the RCS students just from my experience, what I learned over the past 25 years of my career.
I think that it definitely keeps you on the forefront of modern technology and making sure that we are giving our students the most up-to-date information, keeps them current.
Many of the companies, mine included, donate all kinds of equipment, and they really set us up with the best of the best. And so it's funny that when you get into this, you tend to learn what your lab has, and that's it. And so this is another really good service of the RCS program, is that you get exposed to things you may not normally see in your lab.
We also want to train our students to become the IVF leaders in the field, to direct and manage IVF labs and also conduct independent research in the reproductive science. The networking is important. With the 20 years of experience working with students, and we are so happy and honored to see our students go forward to become the leaders in the field.
I'm a lab director now. I'm always looking for embryologists to hire. I'm always going to have colleagues that I'm looking to talk to at meetings, or it's going to be the next wave of lab directors that I'm going to be collaborating with.
But a lot of what I like is really networking opportunities as well, and meeting other people in the field and kind of building and maintaining friendships with other people, or people that you could bounce ideas off of, from other students to the professors to the advisors.
You know, the EVMS program has been instrumental in my development, and I think also the development of the field. The fact that they offer a master's degree as well as a PhD program is pivotal to bring good practitioners into the field to service the future.
So this field is growing by leaps and bounds. Every lab I can think of is looking for embryologists. And that's another great thing about this program, is it's getting people out there, getting people aware of what needs to be done and how to do it, and learning the process, even to get your foot into a lab. But if you have an understanding of the science, of the hands-on, of all of those things. So it makes you marketable, you're serving the labs out there and the fertility patients. It's a great thing.